Fibromyalgia is something that's affecting, you know, so many patients that I see every day in the office here, and it's often accompanied by fatigue and other symptoms. And there's not one way to treat fibromyalgia, and I think it needs to be customized and very much personalized. So one of the things we do is, number one, we may look for a gut health, because the GI tract communicates with, in some ways, with our immune system and communicates with how our muscles and joints and tendons and ligaments respond. We also know that different infectious agents, viruses and bacteria, and especially those who had COVID and sometimes long COVID, we're seeing more and more fibromyalgia symptoms in those patients. So we have to look at those patients individually. We have to look for food sensitivities, because what we eat can greatly affect the aches and pains that we might be feeling in fibromyalgia symptoms. We also have to look for different trace elements, toxic metals, other chemicals in the body, and really do a thorough, full, personalized and customized evaluation on each patient, because no two people are the same. And the triggers and things that might be triggering their fibromyalgia could be very different from one person to another. We had one patient that was, we found it was profoundly hypothyroid, had an underactive thyroid that was contributing to her fibromyalgia, and we had to treat the thyroid in order for the fibromyalgia to clear up. So that's just one little example. I've had another patient, I remember, who we took off wheat and dairy products, and her fibromyalgia greatly improved. So these are two totally different situations, but both of them improve the fibromyalgia. You know, it's not about just covering up symptoms with an antidepressant, anti-anxiety drug. That's not the answer for fibromyalgia. And truthfully, it's not the answer for most clinical conditions that I see in my practice. And that's why we use, you know, more of an integrative, functional, holistic approach to try to individualize the care and look for the root cause and what's triggering the symptoms in each patient individually. Fibromyalgia is something that it's usually a diagnosis of exclusion. They rule out all the other things first. If they can't find any specific named diagnoses, then they might say, you still have your aches and pains and joint troubles and such, and fatigue, they might say, well, you have fibromyalgia. We often, you know, find some of the fibromyalgia patients are low in magnesium. And once we treat them with magnesium or zinc and some of the other trace minerals that feed the mitochondria, which are the powerhouses of our cells, are often so depleted and so dysfunctional in patients with fibromyalgia that once we start addressing that, the fibromyalgia clears up. There are so many different things that can be done and addressed. And I think in a holistic, integrated functional medicine practice, such as ours here at the Magazine or Center for Wellness, you know, that's why we've had so much good success with this condition. So I hope that was helpful for you. And I feel that we can greatly help you if you have these types of symptoms.